Hello and welcome to this brand new series called Setting Up Todoist for Beginners. My name is Carl Pullein and I am here to help you get the most out of this incredible application. Now, Todoist is essentially a to-do list manager. It manages the to-dos that you have to do each day. Now, in this first episode, what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you how to set up projects, because without projects, you don't actually have any way of managing your tasks that you're collecting. So hopefully you've taken my free COD course, that's collect, organize and do, so that you have a pretty good idea of how to use a to-do list manager effectively. If you haven't, don't worry, this little short episode will help you set up, and there are links to the course. It's a free course in the show notes below. If you don't want to take the course, that's perfectly fine. So in this first episode, what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you how to set up projects in Todoist. And in future episodes, we're going to go through settings and we're going to go through task managing, how to set up tasks properly. And we're going to cover the paid premium version episode features as well, which are the labels and the filters and the comments and various other things. Todoist is an incredibly powerful application. So without further ado, I would just like to say, if you do get any value from this video, then please help me by clicking on that like button below. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, and you want to get all the latest tips, tricks, and news on using Todoist, then please subscribe to my channel. Okay, let me take you into my demo account, and I'm going to show you how to set up projects in Todoist. Okay, so when you're new to Todoist, what you're going to do is you're going to open up your Todoist window, and I would always advise to set up the basic setup either in the desktop app or through the web app itself. Now, either way, it works and it will look identical like this. If you're trying to set it up on the mobile device, it is possible, but it's a little bit more fiddly and you're going to be doing a lot of clicking about to find places. The simplest and easiest place to actually create your basic setup is in the web app or the desktop app. And I've got the desktop app open right here. Now, when you're new to Todoist, what you'll find is you'll have a number of sample projects down here. I've deleted those because this is one of my old demo accounts, so I deleted them a long time ago and I don't remember what they are. But what I want to show you in this episode is I want to show you how to add a project. So what we're going to do is you go to this section here and it says add project, so we're just going to click on that. And we're going to call this home, and I'm going to make this italic, so I'm just going to call this home. I'm going to give it my favorite color, so you can change the color here. So I'm going to give this sky blue, let's say. Now, just ignore this bit here because this is part of a beta version, or beta version as we say in the UK, and I will come to this part in a later episode. For now, I want you to worry just about this. And if you're using the main Todoist account, the current version of Todoist as of August 2020, this is what you're going to see. This is something that's coming in the next few weeks, one would hope. So all I'm going to do is I've got my name of my project here, which is going to be home, and we're going to give this a color of sky blue. So I'm going to add that one. So now underneath projects, I have home. Now this is just one way to set up projects. There are many other ways, and in a later episode, I will show you some different ways of how you can manage your projects. For now, in this particular episode, I just want to show you how to set up the projects. Let's create another one. I'm going to call this work. And again, I'm going to capitalize that. That's just a personal preference. I'm going to give that a color of red. I'm going to add that. So what we've done now is we've got two projects set up, home and work. Now you have another one up here, which is your inbox. This is where you're going to be collecting stuff. Now you'll be collecting your ideas, your tasks, and you throw them all into inbox. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to create a task in my inbox, and I'm going to give this a title of, let's say, by Barney. Barney is the name of my dog. Some more medicine. So I'm going to add that task. Now all I'm doing is just grabbing that one there and I've just given it a task. So to add a task, all I need to do is click on here, add a task, or I can type the keyboard shortcut Q, which will bring up this. So let's do another one and say do my expenses report. So we'll just add that one in. And let's add another one. So there's another one that you could do, is just
tap Q and you'll get the window to open up a new task. Or let's just add in another one from the standard way, so we can just add in add task here, and let's just say take garbage out. Okay, so those are things that just say I just want to remember those three things. So when it comes to processing, when it comes to moving these to projects, now you have a number of ways of doing that. This is one of the beauties of Todoist. Let me just enlarge that a little bit so you can see it a bit better. So what we're going to do is the first one here is buy Barney some more medicine. Now the first question I need to ask myself is, which project does that relate to? Well, that's a home project. So what I'm going to do is I can get hold of the six dots here. It's called what we call the grab handles, and I can just move them by dragging and dropping that to my home project. And that's one way of managing your projects. Now another way, which is a little bit more you can add more detail here, is by just clicking on the task. So if I click on the task here, now I have a number of options. I can create a subtask, I can add comments, I can add activity. Now it depends on whether you have the paid version or not. I'm just going to focus on the features in your free version right now. So let's just say I want to move this to my work project, because doing my expenses is related to work. So all I do is I click on this section here, and if you hold over that, you can see select a project. So I'm going to tap that, and I'm going to add that to my work project. That's now moved to my work project, and I can click out. So now I've got two items. So only one item left in my inbox. So my home, I've got one here, buy Barney some more medicine. And work, I've got do my expenses report. And finally, with this one, take garbage out. Again, the question I need to ask myself is this a home or a work project? It's a home project. So another way that you can do that is if you just go to the little edit icon here, this is edit, so I can click on that. And what I can do is I can do the hashtag, and that's going to bring up some options for projects. So I can have inbox, home, or work. Well, take garbage out is home, so I can click on that. That's now adding my home, and I can click on that, and there you go. I've just cleared my inbox. So that's what you need to know about setting up projects. And this is just a really basic setup, your home and your work. There are a lot of other things that you can add. One of the things, if you've ever read the GTD book, one thing you might want to do is create a someday maybe project. Now, a someday maybe project is really all about things that you would like to possibly do in the future. And, you know, maybe you want to do that. So I'm going to add that as a project there. So that's come down at the bottom. So now I have three projects. And let's just say I want to add a task directly into there. So rather than going through the inbox, I want to add a task in there. And let's say someday maybe learn to fly a helicopter. Helicopter. And there we go. And that's someday maybe task, and that's it. So that's gone directly into that particular project. So just to sum up this video for you, the first one is setting up these projects. All you need to do is add project. Click on here to add a project. You get a load of options. And as I say, this is something that you want to ignore right now, because this is just part of the beta version, but it's coming. Add to favorites, that's something that you can do. Now, this is an interesting one, and I'll just come out of here. Let's just come out of there, cancel. Let's go into my home. Let's go into my work one. Let's just say that this is a project that I want to put into favorites. So what you do is you click on the three dots at the side. So when you move your mouse, you can see that I get these three dots. So what I'm going to do is I can come over here, and I can edit the project. So I'm going to click on that. And now I have a few options. I'm going to add this one to my favorites, and I'll show you what happens. When I add it to my favorites, it comes up here. So now I have work in two areas. Now, this is just something that means that now it's really easy to be able to quickly access that project. Now, you can add favorites for labels and filters, and which again, I will cover in a future episode. And there are other options that you have within this particular drop-down menu. So I can edit the project, I can share the project, so I can add it to people, I can archive and delete the project from here. I can also rename the project as well. So if I click on edit, I can now go in there and rename that project if I wish. So there you go. That's all I wanted to cover on projects. I just wanted to give you a really basic overview on how to get set up your projects. So the first thing you'd want to do is, with all those demo projects that you have, is you want to go in here and either archive or delete them. You can do down here, and then set up your own project. So your homework before going on to the next episode, and I want you to do, is to set up a basic structure for your project. So home and work is fine. We can start dealing with those a little later on, but I just wanted to get you started with the projects so that you can get yourself running and get some tasks in there. We'll cover other stuff later in another episode. So there you go. Thank you very much for watching this episode, and it just remains for me now to wish you all a very, very productive week.
Hello, thank you very much for watching my videos. Now I have something exciting to tell you about. Recently I have developed a brand new time management system. It's a system designed to manage your time in the 21st century. The world has changed a lot over the last 20 years. In fact, it's actually changed a lot this year. And what we need now is a system, a time management system, that is very easy to use, easy to maintain, so that you can spend more of your time doing the work. And that's what the time sector system is all about. It's going to change your whole belief system about the way a time management system should work, because this focuses on when you are going to do the task. And let's be honest, it doesn't matter how motivated, inspired, or how urgent something is. If you don't have time to do it, it is never going to get done. And that's what this system is built around, getting your work done, so you can spend more of your time doing the things that you want to do. I hope you join me in this course. The full details of the course are in the show notes below, so please join me, and thank you very much for watching this brief video.